It started as a simple question. After seeing this image countless times when playing Minecraft, I had to know. Where was it taken? What is the seed to this iconic mountain image? Well, after 8 months of searching, I'm happy to announce that the seed to Pack.PNG has finally been discovered. So here it is. Seemingly impossible happened. A seed to an image that was only 128 by 128 pixels was discovered. Getting to this point was no easy feat, to say the least. It took the help of literally thousands of people to pull this off. There were people who made recreations, AI image upscalers. We had developers, and even volunteers who collectively allocated their graphics cards to brute force 281 trillion different world seeds. I would have never thought that a project of this magnitude would be sparked from a simple video that was posted 8 months ago. To see this all unfold was certainly an experience on its own. So how was Pack.PNG actually found? Well, let's just say that a lot of different techniques were tried, but most ended up in dead ends. One of the potential methods I mentioned in my last Pack.PNG video involved using tree positions to gather a list of potential chunk seeds, which would have eventually been converted into potential world seeds. However, due to the sheer amount of chunk seeds and other complications with things like finding the chunk borders and getting the coordinates, it ended up not being a viable option. After this, the project stagnated. Ideas were running low and enthusiasm diminished. But all of this changed when a new seed-finding project arose, the Minecraft title screen. This project innovated in so many different ways that were never even thought of during the original phase of the Pack.PNG project. One of the biggest innovations was building a recreation with the help of a live overlay. This was extremely useful for finding the exact block placements when compared to the original title screen image. However, with Pack.PNG, aligning the view perfectly wasn't so easy this time around. A few extra things were needed. The resolution of the original screenshot, the cropped size of the image, the position of the crop, the camera angle, and camera position. First off, getting the original screenshot resolution was not an easy task in and of itself. Kay and Polymetric gathered a few screenshots and videos that were made by Notch around the same time Pack.PNG was added to the game, and while they concluded Notch most likely used a 1600 by 1200 monitor, his game window wasn't usually in full screen mode, so the exact vertical resolution stayed unknown because he changed the size of his taskbar quite often. From there, the image was cropped down to 512 by 512 pixels, and then downscaled to 128 pixels, which is what was used in the game. This was discovered by Tom Latsko when he studied the pixelated borders of the clouds in the original image. He found out that the color blending at the edges perfectly matched that of a 4x downscale. That information was then used to reverse the effects of the downscaling and bring many parts of the image back to their original resolution. This ended up helping with another effort that was currently going on, finding the exact camera perspective that this image was taken in. There were earlier attempts made by pseudogravity to figure out the camera angle mathematically, but this proved insufficient and a better approach was needed. So he and another team member, Vathos, used a method called regression fitting, which used a bunch of math to gradually fine-tune all the different parameters that influence the perspective. This algorithm attempted to find the camera position, rotation, and the cropping origin by aligning the perspective with 318 marked corner points on the image. This was a lengthy process with multiple attempts made, but the final result was a nearly sub-pixel-perfect recreation of the image. This was crucial for determining some otherwise unrecognizable blocks in the recreation, as well as figuring out the exact z-coordinate by using the clouds. Clouds in Minecraft only move on one axis, and while it was difficult to pin down from such a distance, the pixel-perfect perspective made it possible in the end. While getting the z-coordinate was a hard, but possible task, getting the exact x-coordinate was thought to be downright impossible at first. It seemed like there was nothing in the image that would reveal the hill's x-coordinate. Earth Computer, however, was able to write a program to rule out about half of the x-coordinates by using the dirt and stone patterns visible on the side of the hill. Like many features of Minecraft terrain generation, the thickness of the dirt layer at any particular point is mostly determined by Perlin noise maps, which depends on the world seed. But Minecraft also adds an additional bit of randomness to the dirt thickness, which acts to introduce small bumps and dips. Luckily enough, this process occurs in the same way that generates bedrock patterns, and just like those, this extra source of randomness is the exact same for every world. For a while, a 50% reduction was all that was thought to be possible, but then pseudogravity found that he can do better by using a statistical approach instead. He simulated millions of seeds at different coordinates, and found that these tiny changes in the dirt thicknesses were just enough information to not only confirm the z-coordinate, but also reveal the x-coordinate as well. Now that the team had the exact coordinates of where the hill was located, it was time to figure out the world seed. How it was done was actually pretty straightforward. If we look below the mountain, and especially under the water, there's patterns of dirt and sand. These patterns are different for each world seed. By creating extremely optimized code, the entire list of possible world seeds, 2 to the 48, can be searched through to find which world seeds matched this exact pattern. It was certainly possible, but even with how efficient the code was, it would still take years for any single person's computer to process them all. That's where the Minecraft at Home Boink project comes in. Boink is a piece of software that allows anyone to contribute their computing power to one singular project. So Boysanic took the code and implemented it into Boink so that anyone with a powerful enough NVIDIA GPU can contribute. And boy, did they contribute. At one point, we had a total of 3,500 people dedicating their GPUs to this project. That amount of combined computing power is reaching supercomputer status. In the end, the team was left with around 700,000 world seeds that matched the dirt and sand combination. These were then narrowed down with a less efficient but more accurate seed checker that took into account the shape of the terrain. Since 700,000 seeds isn't really that much, Cortex decided to run the final program on his computer. The program started searching through all 700,000 seeds. At 20% completion, no seed. 50%, nothing. 80%, nada. As it kept creeping closer to 100, everyone started to get worried. What if one of the coordinates was wrong? What if we missed a block? Right as it was creeping to 95% completion, this happened. This was actually the sound that played on Cortex's computer when the seed was found. And trust me, it was a lot louder on his end. But there it was. The Pack.PNG image was now found at 4 o'clock in the morning. Thank God I was awake, because it was a Friday night and I was just getting home from a night out with some friends. As I sat down at my desk, I checked my Discord like I always do, and I saw a message from Cactus, one of the major contributors to the social aspect of the Pack.PNG project. She told me that Pack.PNG was found. I knew immediately that I had to tell as many people as possible, so I dashed to Twitter and announced it to everyone. I also made an announcement on my Discord server shortly after. But nonetheless, we got it. It sure took a while, but it was well worth it. So many people were involved in the Pack.PNG project that it would be impossible for me to list everyone by name, as there's literally thousands of contributors. So in the description, I'll have a full list of credits for anyone who contributed to the project that will be updated as needed. I urge everyone to take a look at this, because some of the things that these people did were just incredible. I also want to especially thank the team who started working on the Pack.PNG project literally hours after I uploaded my first video. Even though they weren't successful at first, those people should not be forgotten. Pack.PNG was by far the most challenging seed finding project that has ever been conducted in Minecraft history. At first, many called it impossible, but you can never underestimate the Minecraft seed cracking community. It didn't matter that it took 8 months. What matters is that it was eventually found, and along the way, so many friendships were made. new techniques were discovered, and many new skills were gained from it. And even already, new projects are starting to arise. If you've ever seen this picture, yeah, the Minecraft at Home team has started to work on finding the seed for this world too. There's even work being done to find the seed to a Minecraft painting. In the 9 years I've been playing Minecraft, I've never even noticed that there was terrain behind this. Now, if you want to see Pack.PNG for yourself, we created a server with the Pack.PNG world that you can join right now. And we'll keep it running, as long as there's at least some interest. I also really want to give a big shout out to PebbleHost for letting us use one of their servers to host Pack.PNG with such short notice. Anyways, in all, there were so many people who dedicated a huge part of their time and effort to the Pack.PNG project. This was a group effort. Without the help of each other, none of this would have been possible. Well, this is it. Our journey is now over. After 8 long months from when I uploaded my first Pack.PNG video, we finally found it. So, now what? Well, I need to do what I always wanted to do.